How you are doing this. If you are doing this, but I need you to help me, Sam. I need to know what is going on. I need the crew. The power is back, but the hatch to Universal is still offline. I need you to find out what the problem is. Sam, give me a systems diagnostic.
Module EAS-1 is pressurized.
Well, the problem must be somewhere else then.
System links in module EAS-1 are connected.
Don't worry about EAS-1, just work out why I can't access Universal.
Module, UN-1 hull contact points to EAS-3 are unresponsive.
This sounds bad. Okay, so the power is fine, but the hull connection points are misaligned. That we can fix. I can't get them open from here, but you should be able to reclamp the contact points from outside. Looks like you're going on your first spacewalk, Sam. Before you go outside, though, we need to update your sphere firmware to allow for exterior use. To upgrade, you'll have to scan the barcodes in EAS 11. Once you're fully updated, we'll get you outside. I'm granting you EVA permission now. The internal airlock hatch is now open. Great, that's you all set up. Okay, get those module clamps fixed, Sam. The control panel where you can rearrange the clamps is on the outer hull of EAS-3. We could maybe check out a US-12 while we're out here. Sam, it's still there. We can check it out.
I'm in my suit. I don't know what is happening. I was trying to unlock the door after the lockdown and the module started shaking, and then Sam jettisoned the module. How did Sam jettison the fucking module? And he shouldn't be able to do that. I'm going to try and work my way around the station exterior. Ah, shit.
Thank you.
Straight down, Sam. The controls are at the bottom of the EAS arm. Getting closer. Look for the controls on EAS-3.
Thank you.
Please repeat your previous instruction.
Sam, get those clamps disengaged. I'll be watching your feed.
What would you like me to do?
Sam, get those clamps disengaged. I'll be watching your feed.
Thank you.
That's it. The hull connection points are reading true. I think that's working. Yeah, it's working. It's gonna take a few minutes while the module connection runs its pressure checks. Sam, while you're out there, take a closer look at the damage you detected earlier on the station exterior. What can you see?
The solar arrays are showing evidence of torsion and stress.
Whatever this station has gone through, the arrays had no chance. Take a closer look at the China and Russian arms. The damage to the top of them looked pretty severe. Thank you.
What would you like me to do, Emma?
Sam, that damage, any ideas?
An unknown material is present at hull fracture points.
That looks like what I found in EAS-4. What the hell is it? Bring the sphere back inside and meet me in EAS-3. Let's get this hatch open. I hope to God the others are okay.
hatch lights are on. Looks like the connection to Universal is holding. Great work, Sam. Now, lift the lockdown on the hatch, please.